Welcome all the students to my class today. We are discussing on the chapter circles. So let us start today with position of a point with respect to a circle.
Inside the circle 1.
he lies inside the circle 1. Next, for the point B, just put x equals minus 1 and y equals 2. We get minus 1 square plus 2 square minus 4 into minus 1 plus 6 into 2 plus 4. 1 plus 4, 5 plus 4 plus 12 plus 4. 5 4, 9, 12, 21, 25. Greater than 0. Therefore, B lies outside the circle. Outside the circle. Next, for the point C, just put x equals minus 1 and y equals minus 3. We get minus 1 square minus 3 square minus 4 into minus 1 plus 6 into minus 3 plus 4. 9, 1, 10 plus 4 minus 18 plus 4. 4, 4, 8, minus 10, plus 10, 0. That means C lies on the circle. Next, this is very important topic. Intercept made by a given circle on the axis. This circle cuts intercept AB on x-axis and intercept PQ from y-axis. Look, for the points lying on x-axis we have ordinate 0. For the points lying on y-axis we have axis 0. First, for the intercept made by x-axis, the first let us consider the general equilibrium of circle. Let the equation of the circle be x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equals. For the intercept made by the x-axis, we put y equals 0 in 1. Then we get x square plus 2gx plus c equals. Look, this is a quadratic in x and its roots are the axes of the points a and b. Suppose axis of the point a b x1 comma 0 and that of b b x2 comma 0. Therefore, roots of this quadratic are x1 and x2. So, we know x1 plus x2 is minus b by a, that is minus 2g, and product of the roots x1 x2 is c. Now, what is the distance between AB? This is actually mod of x1 minus x2. So we have to ultimately find mod of x1 minus x2. Now we have x1 minus x2 whole square is equal to x1 plus x2 whole square minus 4x1 x2. That is minus 2g whole square minus 4c. So if you take 4 common, you get 4 into c square minus c. This is x1 minus x2 whole square. Therefore, mod of x1 minus x2, this will be 2 root over of c square minus c unit. Therefore, length of the intercept made by this circle on x-axis is 2 root over of c square minus c units. You can apply this result as formula in the coming problem if you can remember it, otherwise you can derive it. So this is the length of intercept made by this circle from on x-axis. Next, let us find the intercept on y-axis. For the intercept made by y-axis, we put x equal to 0. Because on y-axis, axis I is 0. Y-axis, we put x equals 0 in plus. Then we get y square plus 2xy plus c equals 0, and its roots are the ordinates of the point P and Q. Say their coordinates are 0, y1 and 0, y2. Therefore, y1 and y2 will be roots of this quadratic in y. Therefore, we can write y1 plus y2 is minus 2a and y1 into y2 is c. Therefore, y1 minus y2 whole square equals to y1 plus y2 whole square minus 4y1 y2. This will ultimately become minus 2a whole square minus 4c. You take 4 common, x square minus c. Therefore, mod of y1 minus y2, which is actually the length of the intercept PQ, this is equal to 2 root over of x square minus c units. 2 root over of x square minus c units. This is length of the intercept made by the circle from y-axis. This you can also remember to use in future problems as a result or as a formula. Now let us solve a problem on this concept. X-axis at 2 comma 0 and has an intercept of length 4 units on y-axis. Find its equation. Suppose this is our circle. Units on y-axis.
say this is PQ. PQ is of length. PQ is of length 4 inches.
Find the equation of the circle.
Now, the circle may lie in two ways.
The circle may lie above the x-axis or it may lie below the x-axis.
It may lie into say or touching x-axis 2,0 and having intercept of length 4 inches in this way.
So first, follow the fact that the circle touches x-axis at 2,0. We have discussed in our previous classes that when a circle touch x-axis, then absolute value of the ordinate of its center is equal to length of its radius. Okay?
And also here as it touch the x-axis at 2,0, So its center must lie on the line x equals 2, because this is perpendicular and the equation of this line is x equals 2. So writing this way, as the circle touches x axis at 2,0, so its center must lie on the line x equals to 2. Let coordinates of center be 2,0. We consider this center as 2,0. Therefore, length of its radius will be mod beta units.
We know when a circle touches x-axis, then length of its radius is equal to absolute value of the ordinate of the center. That's why length of its radius will be mod beta units. So now the equation of the circle can be written as is x minus 2 whole square y minus beta whole square equals to mod beta whole square. So you get x square plus y square minus 4x minus 2 beta y plus 4 equals 0. Now, for the intercept made by y axis, you have to just substitute x equals 0 here. You have to write it. For the intercept made by y axis, we have to substitute x equals 0 in this equation and get y square minus 2 beta y plus 4 equals 0. Now write, if the points of intersection of the circle with y axis are 0 y1 and 0 y2, then y1 comma y2 are roots of this quadratic in y, and we get y1 plus y2 equals to 2 beta, and y1 into y2 is equals to 4. Therefore, y1 minus y2 whole square equals to y1 plus y2 whole square minus 4y1 y2 whole square. That is 4 beta square minus 16, that is 4 into beta square minus 4. Therefore, mod of y1 minus y2 is 2 root over of beta square minus 4. Now, according to the question, length of intercept is 4 units. Therefore,
we have 2 into root over of beta square minus 4 equals to 4. That gives 4 beta square minus 4 equals to 4. Beta square equals to 8. That means beta equals to plus minus 2. Mind it, this must be plus minus because the circle may lie above the x-axis or it may lie below the x-axis. So ordinate of the center must be positive or negative. Now you can write the equation of the circle as, just put here the value of beta, you get hence the equation of the circles are possible circles are x square plus y square minus 4x minus 2 beta, that is minus plus 2y plus 4 equals, or you can write it separately, x square plus y square minus 4x minus 4 root 2y plus 4 equals 0, or x square plus y square minus 4x plus 4 root 2y plus 4 equals 0. These are the possible equations of the circle. We have completed our theoretical portion. Now we have to solve problems from this chapter. Rectangle ABC, equation of the perpendicular sector of AC is this. If the coordinates of the points A and B are this, find the equation of the line BC and center of the circumcircle of triangle ABC.
Can be taken as
2x plus 3y plus k equals 0. Just interchange the coefficient and the sign between them. 2x plus 3y plus k equals 0. As it passes through, the point A 1 minus 1, therefore 2 into 1, 3 into minus 1 plus k equals 0. That implies k equals to 2 minus 3 minus 1, that is k equals to 1. Therefore, equation to the side AC. Equation to the side AC is 2x plus 3y plus 1 equals 0. We get equation to AC as 2x plus 3y plus 1 equals 0. Okay. We are asked to find equation to the side BC. Okay. Now if we solve AC with this particular bisector, then we get coordinates of the point E. E is midpoint of AC. So to get E, we have to solve these two equations. I am erasing all this. Solving 3x minus 2y plus 8 equals 0 and 2x plus 3y plus 1 equals 0. We get x by y by 1 by x by this will be minus 2 minus 24. Y by this will be 60 minus 3, 1 by this is 9 plus 4. So x will be minus 26 minus 2, y equals to 1. So coordinates of E we get minus 2 comma 1. Coordinates of E minus 2 comma 1, right? Therefore, coordinates of E are minus 2 comma 1. Now find slope of D. This will be 0 minus 1, 2 minus minus 2, that is 2 plus 2, that is minus 1 by 4. Now as D and E are midpoints of AB and AC, so from our class 9 geometry, we know DE parallel to BC, that is BC parallel to DE. That implies slope of BC is also minus 1 by 4. Now BC passes to 3 comma 1, we can easily find equation to the side BC. Equation to the side BC is y minus 1 by x minus 3 is equals to minus 1 by 4. This will be 4y minus 4 equals to minus x plus 3. So x plus 4y equals to 7. X plus 4y equals to 7. This is equation to the side BC. Next, we are asked to find coordinates of circumcenter. How do we get this? Find particular bisector of AB, then solve it with this particular bisector, we get circumcenter. Now, slope of AB.
1 minus minus 1 by 3 minus 1. 1 minus 1 is 1, 3 minus 1. 2 by 2, that is 1.
Therefore, slope of the perpendicular bisector will be minus 1. So write equation. To the perpendicular bisector of AB is y minus 0 by x minus 2 equals to minus 1. So y equals to minus x plus 2, that is x plus y equals to 2. This is the equation of this bisector. And we already have 3x minus 2y plus 8 equals 0. Equals to minus 8. Now we have to solve these two equations. So multiply the first equation by 2, we get 2x plus 2y equals to 4. This is 3x minus 2y is minus 8. Add them, you get 5x equals to 4 minus 8, that is minus 4. Minus 4 by 5. X is minus 4 by 5 and then y. Y will be 2 minus 6. This is 2 plus 4 by 5. 5 to the 10, 14 by 5. So therefore, coordinates of the circumcenter will be minus 4 by 5, 14 by 5. This is coordinates of circumcenter. So let us end today's class here. In our next class, we will solve more problems on this chapter to clarify your concepts. Okay. Till then, goodbye. Bye.